Back in 2002, if you wanted a portable music player but couldn't afford an iPod, you might have gotten one of these instead. This is a Creative Nomad Jukebox 2LX, 20 GB, but it's definitely larger than any iPod. It's almost as big as a portable CD player, and there's a reason for that, which I'll show later. And it looks a lot like a portable CD player with the circular design here and all these buttons and the little display. On the back, we get a 5-volt DC power input, a USB socket for connecting to your computer, and the battery compartment. It uses one of these rechargeable lithium-ion batteries. This one is totally dead, does not hold a charge, but you can still get these for around 15 bucks. But I happen to have a 5-volt DC power supply, which works just fine with it. I got this for $1.99 at the thrift store. If we plug in the power supply, we get the copyright message showing 2002. And then it shows the EAX logo, which was Creative's audio processing DSP, which can do things like reverb and volume compression and equalization, which is all in the menu here. You get a little wheel on the side for going through the menus, and it is a green backlit display. Now if we go into the settings, we can see this one has 2,980 tracks on it. It has about 7.8 gigabytes free out of the 19 or so gigabytes total. If we go into the music library, you can see all the different artists that are on here. And with all these songs on here, I would like to copy them to my computer. So if we plug in the USB, it is recognized by the computer, and I was able to find the drivers on Creative's website. It is recognized as a portable media device. If we click on it, we can see all the songs are on it. But the only thing it lets us do is delete the files. If I try to drag and drop a file to my documents, you can see it has do not symbol there. That's the copy protection. And if I start up Creative's own software here, Creative Media Source 5 Organizer, it shows all the files. But if I try to copy it to the PC Music Library, it says unable to upload protected track. So it only lets you copy music from your computer to the Nomad. It doesn't let you copy it the other way around. So to get around that, I thought of opening this thing up and taking out whatever kind of hard drive is in there and connecting it to the computer directly. I first thought this might use a 1.8 inch hard drive, just like the iPods did. But then I also saw online that somebody said these use a micro drive. I thought this thing is a little bit too big to have a micro drive in it. But if we pop off the back cover, we can see the answer is it uses a full-size 2.5 inch laptop hard drive. This one's actually from 2003. It's a Fujitsu 20 gig laptop hard drive IDE. So I'm going to try to take this thing out and connect it to the computer and see what I can do with it. There's the other side of the circuit board. It says copyright 2002, assembled in Singapore. And I just need to unscrew the hard drive, and then I should be able to pop off the connector and connect it to the computer. And there is the hard drive removed. When I was taking out, one of these metal washers fell out and went off to lands unknown, but with my magnet, I should be able to find it later. But for now, here's the hard drive all disconnected. There you can see the other side of the circuit board with some of the custom chips on it. So it should also be possible to upgrade one of these to a larger hard drive. Just get a regular laptop IDE hard drive and stick it in there, and it should work. Now I have it connected to one of these IDE or SATA to USB adapters. Has connectors for both 3.5 inch and 2.5 inch IDE. So now I just need to plug in the USB to my computer. It does show up in the disk manager, but it says it's unallocated. So it must be some kind of proprietary format, or maybe a Linux format. So I'll need to do some further research to find out what kind of partition is actually on there. Well, trying to access the data from the hard drive directly proved to be fruitless, so I hooked it up back to the Nomad, and I found a program called NomadSync, which can transfer the data from the player to the PC, and I was able to upload one track here into my Windows Music folder, and now I can play it on the computer. So I can go through these tracks and upload them, but I hope I don't have to do them one by one, because I don't know if there's any way to do a whole bunch at once here. So I can just upload one and do actions. Now it's uploading. So hopefully I can figure out some way to select them all and upload them all in one shot. Okay, that was easy enough. It's just like a spreadsheet. Just click on the little corner here and it selects everything. I was able to select upload to PC. Now if I do actions, it should, yep, it's going through and uploading all the files to the PC. So all it took was this little freeware program called NomadSync. And I'm copying about 3,000 songs from that hard drive to the computer. So that sure beats buying them on iTunes. Instead of a dollar each, I paid $2 for 3,000 songs on that thing. Of course, most of them are 128 kilobit MP3 files, so not exactly the best quality, but I'll take what I can get. And this also supports WMA files, I found out. I was able to get all those files uploaded to the PC, so now when I open NomadSync, it comes up blank because it recognizes that I don't have any files left to sync from the Nomad to the PC. And Windows shows that I have 2,851 files in the music folder that I transferred from the Nomad. I know it said 3,000 something on the display there, but maybe the rest of those were WMA files because the NomadSync program only supports MP3. So maybe there's some WMA files on this thing that I will be unable to transfer, but at least I got the majority of the music off of this and onto my computer. So that's the Creative Nomad Jukebox 2LX, one of many competitors to the iPod, which didn't make it in the long run, but still pretty usable. And for $2, I definitely can't complain.